Welcome to the Dream Life is Real Life podcast with your host, Hannah Hermanson, bringing you real life stories of people who realized their dreams to educate and inspire you to create your legacy of abundance now.
Hey, you know, I'm back with another inspiring guest. Today, we are hanging out with Dave Domzalski. He is the founding editor and writer of Hero Story, herostory.org. That's a newsletter that highlights amazing entrepreneurs doing incredible things for their families, communities, and the world. His coverage of uplifting, positive stories of entrepreneurs making an impact provides readers with the inspiration, education, and motivation to be heroic in their own lives. Oh my gosh, sounds just like this show. Dave's writing and branding expertise has been featured in AOL, Forbes, MSN, Skillshare, Thrive Global, and Yahoo, along with his blogs Run the Money and Financial BIM. So Dave, welcome to the show.
Thank you so much for having me, Hannah. Pleasure to be here.
Yeah, it sounds like you're everywhere, and this is a perfect next pit stop for you because we are all about educating and inspiring other go-getters. So I'm excited to dive in with you.
So excited to be here, you know, and that's really what I'm all about, so let's do it.
Good. So I'm always curious, you know, how people get to where they're at, and you've got multiple blogs, you've been featured in a lot of publications, so have you always been a writer, or what's your background?
You know, actually, my background is primarily in accounting. That's what I went to school for. And actually, I still work in that capacity full time. But I've always had a knack for writing. It's always been something that, you know, I don't want to sound cocky or have a big ego or anything, but it's always something that's really come easy to me. I've always really enjoyed it and really had a passion for it. And it's always been like that one thing that, you know, you could screw up for the rest of your life in different ways and you go down different paths. But for whatever reason, people have always told me that, hey, Dave, you're a great writer. I wrote for my high school newspaper, the yearbook editor. I was assistant sports editor for my college newspaper. So it's always been something that I've never done like in a full-time capacity or anything like that, but it's always been something that I've clung to, and it's something that I was able to offer the world as a gift. And it's just, it's just been something that's always stuck with me. And, you know, taking it into like a side hustle was kind of a natural fit. And, you know, as I navigated the online space and everything like that, it just, I tried to make the writing the center point because that was what I was good at. And I kind of just, you know, learned everything else as I went, but just kind of let the writing speak for itself.
I love this, Dave. So looking back, I'm in a similar way, kind of connected the dots to be like, I was always kind of this like entrepreneur, but where do you channel that, right? Like growing up, there was no like entrepreneur club, but there was like, debate club or forensics, and for you, like the yearbook and stuff. And I think that one of my passions is to really rethink education and how the opportunities you had in high school to do like yearbook and those things did lead to the blogging and all of that. But did you ever think when you were even like in high school, did you ever think like, yeah, I'll like have a digital platform where I get to share stories and I'll always get to write? Or how did you like get into the online space? I mean, did the internet even exist then? I just think it's interesting to look back.
Well, I hope you realize I'm not that old. I mean, I did graduated high school in 02 and college in 06, but I'm not a dinosaur over here with the. The internet was just, 02, you're talking still dial up. Right. So no, I mean, the whole concept of, you know, having your own blog outside of like, you know, it was like forums, AOL chat, AIM, all that kind of stuff. Mm-hmm. Like, no, I mean, it was never a thought. I mean, you know, I was kind of, I just kind of assumed that I would be in the business world at some point. And, or, you know, when I went into college, it was going to be something along the accounting lines. Writing was always like a supplement. That's kind of what the mindset I had growing up and what I was taught. But, you know, the internet just gives you so much opportunity. I mean, you can become an influence. You can craft yourself in that way. You can find a way to deliver a message that resonates with people. And that's just the beauty of it. And so, you know, primarily we're consuming things now, obviously, via the written word. You know, down the line it's probably going to transition more to voice, but right now writing's in its prime, and it's, you know, at max capacity.
Mm-hmm.
So just plenty of opportunity.
Absolutely. And another thing I appreciate about what you're saying is that balance, right? Like, you still work full time. You like did the college thing, but you've pursued this knack, and to be able to still incorporate that into what you do day to day and what you're able to leave in the world, I think is something I hope listeners are hearing, right? That like not every successful blogger or entrepreneur only has like one pot boiling at a time.
Exactly. And, you know, I don't want people to think that, I mean, it's okay not to just pursue the, you know, the full time, you know, the side hustle that becomes full time. Obviously that's a lot of us that are doing this, including me. That's our goal, but it's okay to kind of hone your craft and get better. I mean, I started my first blog, Financial Ben, in 2010. So it's been a journey for me. It's been a mm-hmm. journey for, you know, building an audience. It's been a journey to, you know, have the confidence to even approach outlets like Forbes and editors like Forbes, and using LinkedIn and networking on social media, and even being able to do podcasts like this. Just, it takes a lot of bravado and a lot of just courage to be able to put yourself out there. So, but you know, there's nothing wrong with working the full-time job and then burning the midnight oil, or using your lunch break, or, you know, even asking your significant other if you have children, hey, can I take an hour in the morning? Can I take an hour at night? Mm-hmm. Just honing your craft when you have your downtime. You know, for situations like this where you're working full time and pursuing something else, it's that extra time, it's that downtime when you're not working that you can actually build your wealth and build a name for yourself.
Oh, and you guys, we all have it. Like, hello, delete your Facebook app, ignore Instagram, like put down the Netflix. I think it's super interesting because I work with some people who still have a full-time job, and they'll ask me like, are you sure I can do this? Like, do I have time? And I was like, how much time do you spend on Facebook? Oh God, I check it all. I'm like, great. You'll find the time if you can, exactly. You know, we all do have excess time. It's just about prioritizing our time.
So, amen.
So Dave, you mentioned before we started that you're raising a young family and working full-time and managing multiple blogs. So if you could speak to another go-getter who has a family and lots mm-hmm. of pots boiling, if you will, what would you like to say to them? Or maybe what do you need to coach yourself on today?
Man, you know, so much, I would say, because I think nowadays, like, there's so many things clamoring for our attention.
Mm-hmm.
I would say be intentional with your time and put your phone down.
Yeah.
that's really what it comes down to. I mean, you know, you have so many buzzes, and I mean, I actually turn off all notifications on my phone. I don't want to be notified of things.
Airplane mode is how I live my life.
Yeah. I mean, if I got to check a Facebook message or a status or something, I'll go and actually go and check it. Like, I don't want to be notified, because when I'm working, when I'm in the zone, I want to be in the zone. I turn the phone over, I put it on silent. When I'm with my family, I want to be present with my kids. You know, I mean, my kids are involved in so many activities. I'm actually going to be starting to coach my son in T-ball on Sunday.
Oh, so sweet.
So, I mean, I gotta be present. I gotta be there, because, you know, otherwise you're not there. I mean, you're there physically, but you're not there mentally. And, you know, that doesn't make for a really solid relationship with your family or a solid output for your job or side hustle. So, yeah, right. I mean, it's all about, yeah, it's finding balance, but it's really being intentional about, you know, how you're going to conduct yourself.
You know, I'm really grateful that you're being so honest with us, because I feel like I have this conversation with a lot of women who feel like they're obligated, like mom guilt, right? That like, okay, I want to build this business. I have a job, and there's T-ball, and there's all of these things, but it's the same principle, right? It's about just like being where you are when you're there, because otherwise you miss it all, right? If you're just doing all the things at once, which
yeah, you missed it. And you know, I mean, even, you know, my wife worked for a while before she became a stay-at-home mom. But even as a stay-at-home mom, I mean, she still has dreams and goals. Mm. I mean, she still has the intention to actually, you know, go back to work eventually. And, you know, she really kicked ass at real. I'm sorry, I may have edited that out.
Yeah, no.
Really kicked butt in real estate. back in the day. And, you know, she still has that desire inside her to do something, because as much as she enjoys being a stay-at-home mom, there's something in her that still has a desire to create, still has a desire to feel like she's bringing value to the table. Even though I try to remind her that, hey, you're raising our children. That's the most valuable thing you can possibly do. Mm-hmm. You know, while I'm working and everything, and, you know, obviously I come and help her out when I'm done. But, you know, I think it's this desire to create and to do and to contribute to the world. You know, I was actually listening to one of your other episodes, and, you know, that mom guilt, that, I mean, I think that's an unfair, undue pressure we put on women, because this innate desire, it's something we're born with, something we're created with. So there's nothing wrong with that. It's just about, you know, prioritizing time for everything in our lives. And that's what it comes down to. It comes down to prioritizing. So my wife, one of the projects she loves to do, she loves gardening. So we try to prioritize that. So when I'm done working, you know, we'll budget time on the weekends or budget time after I'm done, and I'll watch the kids and she'll go do that. And it's a guilt-free. It's not like, you know, I lord it over her or anything like that. You know, so it's about finding that time with your significant other, or, you know, if you're a single mom, you know, maybe you got to put some money in the budget to hire a babysitter or talk and work it out with neighbors or friends and family or something like that. But there's nothing wrong with that. There's nothing wrong with wanting that desire to create and actually and do something else outside of just, you know, being a mother and being a parent. I mean, I do the same thing.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So, okay. So I want to build upon what you're talking about here, this desire to create, because I think that speaks to so many creative people that are listening. And I'm wondering if that is what inspired you to start the hero story, or where did this new, because it's newer than the financial bin, right? The hero story.
Yes. Okay. Yes. It was so to kind of, you know, backtrack, it's financial bin, run the money, and then hero story. And, you know, hero story, I feel like is really the culmination of everything I've been doing online. You know, it really is that desire to create. It's very writing centric, but not that the other things aren't, but I feel like it's where I've really tried to hone in on this, being more of a craft rather than just something I, you know, put up there like five tips for whatever.
Like storytelling.
Exactly. It's storytelling. And it's really trying to engage with the audience in a very vulnerable sense. Like I try to give these stories of these people that people can truly relate to, and then actually not only get inspiration from, but then actually take actionable advice and steps out of and do something with it.
Absolutely. Do you have a favorite? Could you give us like a snippet of one that really spoke to you?
Well, actually the best one, and I covered this gentleman in Forbes, mm-hmm. and he's actually the whole reason that I decided to do Hero Story. His name is Sean Maroney, and he was a very obese individual at one time, weighed like 700 pounds. Mm. And he's taken people on a journey with him it's called the Obesity Revolution. And he's trying to help other people in his situation lose the weight, because more importantly than it being a weight loss journey, it's a journey kind of, you know, going into themselves and realizing like why they got to that weight. It's not always just because of a medical condition. A lot of it has to do with, you know, just depression and just some horrible experiences. Like Sean went through some really tough times. He didn't grow up with a dad. He was abused. He abused drugs. At a very early age. So I was really touched by Sean's story. And I just thought, I mean, I was focused more on the personal finance, but I just saw this and I'm like, I can really bring this story to light, because for Run the Money, I was covering not only finance, but also health. So I thought that Sean's story was just beautiful. And I thought people would really get something out of it. And you know, Hannah, you know, when you're onto something, when the person that is the subject of the story tells you that you touched their heart and that they were actually inspired by their own story and the way you wrote it. Mm-hmm. And having that and carrying that with me and being able to capture that is just such a blessing. It's a blessing to the people that I share with and to Sean, I think, but even more so to me, because I feel like I'm actually making an impact. And I think that's what we really want. We want to know, like, when we leave this earth, that we did something, like something right. that we did matter. No matter how little, we had an impact and we're leaving a legacy.
And I was going to say, that's the dream. right? Yeah, to like exactly. Use your skills, use that thing you have the knack for, and exactly. Empower someone else or share it with someone else, or like create that ripple effect just by sharing the gifts that you already have, that were already within you, instead of just keeping them or sitting on them or
Amen. I mean, I totally agree. And I think that's why, now, this day and age, we're so fortunate to be able to have the platforms we have to be able to get that message out there. Because 100 years ago, 50 years ago, 20 years ago, you didn't have it at this scale.
Right.
And it's amazing. So anyone out there doubting themselves, doubting that they have something to offer, I call BS, because they think everyone has something to offer. And it's just finding a way to offer to the world in the right way.
Oh, and I'm a firm believer that this exact moment, more than any other moment in the universe as we know it, is the time to be putting your value out. And we have so many ways to do it. And there's so many people who are open and receptive and aligned with us. So I love talking to people. I can just feel your energy is so alive when it comes to really, getting your story, getting your skills, getting your purpose out in living color.
Absolutely.
So thank you for sharing that story and also, portraying so many other stories. So I know you'll have an opportunity for folks to learn more about the hero story, but what is maybe the next era or your next need that maybe listeners could support you in with the hero story movement?
Yeah, well, I mean, the main thing right now is I'm trying to get the word out, and I'm trying to get increase the subscriber base. From there, what I'm really working on right now is kind of backfilling the schedule to, find some just incredible people who are doing the amazing things that I want to highlight. I want people that are coming on that are, the husbands, the fathers, the wives, the mothers, who are entrepreneurs, but then also parents who are just in the grind every day. You know what I mean? Because I think that's where we see the Zuckerbergs and the Gateses and, the Brené Browns, all those people like that. But, I think the real, not that they're not heroes, not that they're not significant people that we can learn from, but I think, forgotten in the mix are the everyday people, people that aren't necessarily, covering the headlines, people that are, burning the midnight oil, but then also trying to, work a full-time job and be a parent and stuff like that. We need to highlight those people. I think that's important. So reaching out to me, if you think you're a fit, please let me know. And then from there, where I really see this going, Hannah, is I see it being a podcast. I see more courses coming on down the line. So I'd love to know what people are interested in so we can create the right content. And then from there, I actually see it being almost like a conference style, TED Talk style, where people actually get up and we'll spend 15, 20 minutes and give us exactly what they went through and the hardships and everything. And not just the business side of it, but the person side of it. Because I think that's just as important.
Oh, okay. I'm with you. I'm totally with you. When I saw the blog, I thought this has so much potential to go lots of places. So it's exciting to hear your vision for expansion. And there's so much power in storytelling. And it's interesting to hear someone coming from the financial world to be embracing that and kind of balancing, mm-hmm. The business, the strategy, here's some actions to take. But so much of that learning just comes out of story and kind of building on the shoulders of others.
Yeah. And one thing I want to say about the storytelling aspect, I mean, it's not like storytelling is anything new. I mean, the way we actually passed down history back in the day, eons ago, was through storytelling, through oral tradition. So I think it's something very innate in the human spirit and how we interact with each other. So, it's amazing that it's taking shape in a movement where, everyone's so addicted to their phones.
I know.
It's actually kind of funny. It
totally is. Just this week, I had a conversation with a client who she needed to start putting videos out. It was that time. She wanted to try videos. And she's like, oh, I'm just nervous to do it live. I would just rather record it and edit it. I was like, why? What's the deal with being live? And she had all of these self-doubts. And I was like, you do realize that you've been living your life live. And every person that you've ever talked to has seen you speaking live for the past 35 years. And she's like, oh, I never thought of it like that. And people have recordings of you, they have their own impressions of you in their brain already. You going live on Facebook is no different than real life.
That is a great point, Hannah. And it's like, there's no one in front of you. So you can just, yeah. You don't have to worry about it. You know, just get up there, put the mic on or put the camera on and have at it.
Yeah. You know, and then we also decided as soon as she's done, she was just going to close her computer and not look at the notifications, not worry about the outcome. Just take the action.
Take the action. Exactly. That's all that matters, is taking the action. You'll perfect it as you go.
Exactly. Exactly. Okay. This is amazing, Dave. We're getting to the pop quiz section of the show. So I just have three last.
I didn't prepare.
Oh, you'll be fine. If you can make the high school yearbook, you can make this pop quiz. All right. Okay. So question number one is, what is one action, one thing listeners can do today to get closer to their dream life?
Prioritize the time. Yeah. And I really mean that. Like, don't just put it on the schedule and say, I'll get to it. Actually do it and make it something that you do every day, even if it's for 15 minutes, just a small portion of your day. Take the action. You'll build momentum.
Awesome. A+. Question number two, if you could hand a tangible resource, almost like a gift to listeners, maybe it's a book that changed your life or a conference, what would you hand listeners today?
You know, the book that actually changed my life is Robert Kiyosaki's Rich Dad Poor Dad. And if you've never read it, and you're not really sure whether you want to kind of make the foray into entrepreneurship, I suggest you pick it up, because it's what got me into it. My wife actually gave it to me. She was my girlfriend then. And back in 2007, completely changed my outlook about my accounting, my profession, and then also about how to think about my career and how to think about money. And it really set me on a path to, I mean, it's actually the reason I'm here where I am today.
Mm-hmm. Ah, beautiful. Okay. Last question is, where can people learn more about you and get involved with what you're up to?
Well, I ask that everyone check out herostory.org. It's all one word. And there you'll see some past issues. And on the first page right there, you'll be able to sign up and check out the newsletter. And, you can also hit the About Me page, and you'll learn more about my story and why I started this and where I see it going.
Wow. So good. And who knows, maybe someday I'll see some listeners that get featured or their story ends up over there, which would be
absolutely amazing. And if they give a shout out to you, I'll make sure to link up the podcast.
Yes, everyone, it is about me. Tell him that you know me. Right. All right, everyone. Thank you, Dave, so much for your stories, your time, and your energy. And friends, I'll be back next week with another inspiring guest that will, of course, help you make your dream life your real life.
You've been learning how to make your dream life your real life with Hannah Hermanson. To get the resources mentioned on today's show and to listen to past episodes, visit www.dreamlifeisreallife.com.